All right, so we are here with Jasmine Jones coming off, in my opinion, a legendary 2024 season with so many different things happening. I mean, two-time NCAA champion indoors and out, a US Olympian in the 400 meter hurdles, finished top four at the Olympic Games in the first Olympics. You became like top five all time in the 400 hurdles. And now you're a newly signed racer for Grand Slam track. I mean, overall, just like how you feeling right now at the end of the 2024 season?
No, yeah, that season was definitely like life-changing. I feel like on lots of different like levels. So coming off that season, I just feel really like proud of what I've been able to accomplish and just excited for what's to come, like starting this new chapter of being pro and getting this whole new experience and starting from like ground zero, but also having that experience from the Olympic Games is going to be super exciting and super like helpful going forward for sure.
Nice. And I mean, it's only been like, I guess, 2 or so months, 2, 3 months since the
Yeah,
Olympics.
that's
Like,
insane.
I know. I mean, have you even had time to process what has happened throughout the year?
I mean, yeah, I feel like going into like kind of the fall season and seeing getting all coming home and seeing everyone's congratulations and me hearing from everybody how fun it was to watch and just to like watch the journey unfold has kind of made it sink in that like, oh my gosh, like all this stuff's happened and everyone's like there's so many people rooting for me back at home and even out in LA at school. And yeah, it just makes it feel like when I'm not alone doing it, then it has like much more like meaning.
Nice. And so to dive into the season a little bit, I went back onto your IG and I saw at the end of 2023, I'm going to read this. I'll paraphrase a little bit, but you did post and you said, this was like June 2023. You said, my junior track season has taught me a whole new definition of patience and trust. Despite the disappointment and the pain from this year, I'm not going to let the negatives hold me back. I know my abilities and my potential, and I can't wait for the world to see it too. I can't wait for the next season. It's going to be a good one. And again, little paraphrasing, but I mean, since then, again, you've won NCAA indoors and out. You've gotten to the Olympic Games, right? Top four in the Olympic final. Like, when you were putting that together, coming off all the ups and downs that you had, did you imagine that the season would play out as it did?
Crazily, I did. Like, as soon as the season started, I was like, you know what? Last year was literally horrible. The worst year of season of my life. So this year I'm gonna make it the best. And I'm gonna go to the Olympic Games and I'm going to make this final. And that's what I did. And I was so proud of myself. And getting that fourth spot was honestly, it was at the moment a huge disappointment. And it still is kind of like, ugh. But like I couldn't even be like too upset. And just thinking about like how far I came from having no season to being an Olympic finalist. So just like having that perspective has been so nice to be able to appreciate my own accomplishments without beating myself about it too much.
Yeah, I mean, you definitely deserve a lot of props. Again, you like didn't even you weren't even able to compete. So to be able to like turn things around and really, you know, pick things up and get on the grind, that was, you did amazing this year. So yeah. And then now a little bit looking into next year, you've officially signed on as a racer as part of Grand Slam Track. Again, huge congratulations
Thank
as
you.
another huge step for, you know, for your career as it's just kicking off. What intrigued you about Grand Slam Track that made you decide to sign on as a racer?
Yeah, I think like growing up, I ran track since I was a little kid. So growing up and seeing like kind of the landscape of the professional field has been interesting to kind of learn and see different ways that we could grow as a sport and kind of find places where we can improve. And so whenever there's like a new sort of something new or something different than what's been done, it's always intriguing to kind of be a part of that and try to move the sport forward any way I can. So when I heard about this kind of thing with a season long or like four different races, four different meets, eight different races of like track and field and lots of different sponsors and like energy and excitement. It kind of really intrigued me to try to like be a part of something like that and something that could definitely garner some more attention for our sport.
Yeah, I mean, there is so much. And it's like something that's not traditional in terms of just like, okay, you become pro and then you just, you know, do your races through the year. It's like you said, a little bit different in terms of mixing up for the season. And you'll be doing, of course, 400 hurdles, but then also the 400 as well. Like, I mean, what is that like first in terms of being able to double up there?
I mean, that's definitely a super exciting opportunity. You know, I haven't done the open four, I think, ever. I'm trying to think back. I haven't didn't do it in college ever, didn't do it in high school ever. So get to do that is gonna be super exciting. I mean, going before the season, I had never run 400 hurdles at this level, and then that turned out pretty great. So I'm excited to see how the open four can do. It's like a pretty, I think our training is like gonna be conducive to a good time in either one. So getting to test myself on that high level and getting to especially do it with like all these amazing girls is gonna be super fun.
So that's the thing. I was trying to find if you actually had a 400 like time ever, and I literally just
Yeah.
couldn't find it. I mean,
Right,
you
exactly. There is none. So this is gonna be so fun. I can't wait to
I
see.
mean, okay, so you've run 52.2 in the hurdles, right?
Yeah.
So how can we extrapolate that into the open four? Like, what do you think your
Yeah.
personal best in the four would be?
I mean, people always say it's like a differential for the hurdles in the open four of like a second and a half to like 3 seconds. So I feel like anywhere from like I don't want to put a cap on myself, but like something with a four, hopefully, at the beginning.
Yeah, I mean, yes,
Yeah.
please. Right.
Yeah.
I'm sure you've had some 4x4 splits that have been faster than like a 50 already. So I'm sure you could do it in the open. Now, like you said, you haven't actually run, you just started like seriously running the 400 hurdles like a year ago or so. And then you've, of course, got
Right.
injured beforehand, right? What made you switch into the 400 hurdles as opposed to moving up from the shorts?
I was definitely a 100 hurdler like primarily all through high school and through college, but after honestly watching the Tokyo Olympics and one of my great teammates and friends, Anna Cockrell, I trained with her freshman year and I was like, you know what, like I look up to her so much, so I was like, Anna can do that, I want to try doing that too, like that looks so fun, like just to have something new to track and field, because for me the 100 hurdles and or just doing one event in general can kind of get frustrating of seeing such tiny little improvements in such a long time. So I was like, might as well change it up. My going into my junior year, get some more points for the team. And yeah, I went up to my coach and I was like, Coach Hayes, can I try 400 hurdles? And she was like, I am so glad you asked. And she ran with that and never looked back. So I was like, oh, what did I get myself into? But it's been such a great journey. And honestly, I'm so happy to be in 400 hurdles now. I think it was definitely the event that I was supposed to be in all along. So it's exciting to see where this goes since it's such a new event for me and only it's been like a year and so much improvement. So I'm excited to see where this goes for sure.
I mean, was there any intimidation where it's like, I don't know, a lot of athletes will say if their coach is trying to put them in the 4x4 or into a 400, they're like scared. Was there any intimidation going into the hurdles?
Weirdly, I have more intimidation for the open four than the hurdles. I feel like when people say like, oh, it's the hardest event in track and field, it honestly just makes me want to like try it more because I don't know. I think I have like a weird like draw doing hard things. So sometimes like when people are like, oh man, how do you do that? I'm like, you know what? I don't know. And let me do it better than last time. Like it's just encouraging for me.
Nice. And I mean, so now when you're in Grand Slam track, you're going to, of course, double up on a weekend running the four and the 400 hurdles. How might you approach that, especially considering the competition with some great ladies who you'll be running against, like you
Right.
said?
Right. So I'm pretty sure the hurdle race is first, right? So
I think it might be, yeah.
I think that is helpful to just get that like completed and since that's like my primary event and like what I really do. So once that's kind of finished, I mean, I have my sort of race strategy and my meet day plan for that already. So then going into the next day is honestly super fun to just kind of like test myself and bring like more of like a fun energy to it, I think, because it's less of pressure. There's no pressure, so I have no time prior to this. So I think just getting out there and competing and having fun on this fun stage and at this new environment is going to be super cool.
Nice. I mean, yeah, you'll set a personal best on the first tryout. So
Exactly. So
that'll be dope. Do you, I guess, what do you like more, right? Of course, we're talking, let's get a four in front of whatever time you put in for the 400. But do you look at the time more or do you look at like the competition? Because even like I was watching, of course, the Olympic final back and you had insane grit in that last like 100 meters and you were like fighting of course to get to the line, but like I feel like you have that competitive spirit, but I'm curious like what you like a little bit more.
I think I really just focus on the competition mode for the time. Like, I think the time will come whenever it wants to come, and just having those like extremely challenging races with a great field makes those times come even faster or makes them come eventually. So you don't have to worry about that if you're in such a great environment. I think having a fun competition is definitely like something to look forward to for sure.
There you go. There you go. And now, looking forward, well, even looking forward, but just throughout the entire year, where, of course, signing on to Grand Slam track for 2025, in the middle of Olympic trials while you're going through the rounds, you signed, or at least you announced that, you signed with Adidas and then of course got to the Olympic Games. How have you been able to navigate throughout the year with all these major, changes in your life, but still remain grounded, still remain the best that you can be as both an athlete and as a person?
Yeah, I think like having all those changes occur so close together was actually helpful because then I could have just have one moment of like, oh my gosh, like so much has changed versus having to keep on changing throughout the summer. But the changes were also like super huge blessings, things that I've been hoping for and praying for since I was a little girl. So they were always positive, and it was just exciting to have these different kind of goals come true finally. So there was never any like stress with it, I guess, because this is what I wanted. So I feel just proud of myself for having that happen. But especially also having the same team with me throughout the whole process kept it from feeling too different. Like, I have my same coach, my same training partners, my family was supportive throughout the whole process. So having that kind of core didn't make it feel like it was too big of a change. It kind of felt like I always had that support, so I could always just do what I do, without having to worry.
There you go. That's good when you like are prepared for it. You're looking forward to these things kind of happening, and then they eventually do happen. It's like, okay, this is what I've been looking for. This is what I've been asking for. So nice.
So
That
really
is
just coming
dope.
from a place of like gratitude versus like nerves, I guess.
Do you like ha did you have nerves throughout the process? Because you're coming from the NCAA, you went to the really straight to the pros, to the top of the top. Like, did nerves ever like get the best of you, or did you feel mostly comfortable, as you're like lining up all the through the year?
There were definitely nerves. I think the most nerves I had was at trials, though. Like,
Oh
making
yeah.
that transition was the hard part, I think. Like, staying in Eugene for the trials after NCAAs, I got there like a week before my races started. So I was watching all my teammates come through, make the team, and then go move on. And I was like, oh my gosh, I still haven't competed at all. Like, it was a huge challenge. I honestly think that was like the mental Olympics before the real Olympics, like making my sure that I kept my like self in check and made myself ready to compete, even though it was a long wait. But and we were literally the last final on the last day, which was so funny. But I think also all that waiting made it like even more surreal, just to be like the last addition to our little Olympic team was so. It was such a cute feeling. It's going through processing. Everybody was congratulating me, and I was seeing everybody who made the team, and I was just looking forward to Paris and all the things. So, yeah, the whole experience was great, honestly.
Nice. That is a long time to be waiting, like at the Olympic trials, like a week before things. It's and like you said, you are the last event at the trials. Like
And then going into Paris, I feel like my nerves were for something different. I feel like the nerves at trials were for my own self and for the competition that I was about to do, because I knew I wanted to make this team and it was going to be tough. But then once I made the team and once I was in Paris, the nerves were more like exciting, more like fuel kind of, because getting out on that stage was completely an insane experience with that huge stadium, that huge crowd. So the nerves there were really just like pushing me around the track, honestly.
Nice. Well, again, you did amazing no matter the result in Paris. So you definitely got pushed around. So again, in 2025, this will be your first year competing professionally, like fully throughout the entire year and like on the circuit, of course, here with Grand Slam track. Do you have to kind of shift your mindset coming from the NCAA into your professional year, or do you feel like the Olympic trials and the Olympic Games kind of prepared you for, what's going to be coming in next year?
Yeah, I think the main difference would probably be the amount of competitions. I think in the NCAA, some people can, the season starts a little bit earlier and ends a little earlier. So it's kind of people run themselves into shape, if you know what I mean, like compete all the time and do all these things like indoor and outdoor. But then I think maybe we haven't really completed our like my schedule and set things in stone yet. But for out for professional track, it's looking a, it's a much less competition, I would say. I'm not exactly sure, but it is still seeing like see people I see all the time, like the same competition. So, and even some from the NCAA who have moved up with me, which is going to be super cool to see them at the meets. So I think like having that like same family and same people I see at the meets makes it feel fun to just go out there and like compete with them again.
Yeah, I mean, it will definitely because you won't be running like 4x4s and all that stuff,
Right.
like as
Right,
frequent
like
or
one
at.
round and we're out of there. Like that's wild. Yeah.
That's so true. Yeah, you'll literally like fly to another country and do one round, and then that's it. As
Yeah.
a which would
Yeah.
be, but I
So
mean,
that's like one of the biggest differences.
I'm sure it'll be pretty cool though. Like you said, you'll have a couple people who finished through the NCAA already with you, and then also, of course, you know your teammates who you already train with and stuff like that. So that'll probably be a really good experience for you.
Yeah.
And then on that, do you envision yourself still dipping toes into the short hurdles? Like, I know, like you mentioned, like Anna Cockrell, she, of course, she's double. She hasn't done the 100 hurdles recently, but I don't know. Do you feel like you might miss it a little bit or still dip your toes into it?
Maybe. I think I still always love that race and that event. I think maybe I've heard some, we had some talks about running 60 hurdles indoors. I don't know about 100 meters outdoor yet, but I think indoor could be a place for me to dip my toes back in that water. I mean, that competition is super, super deep, and all those girls are amazing. So it'd be so fun to get in there with them for sure.
Yeah, I mean, you're not an NCAA champion for nothing. So you very much would
That's
be in the
true.
mix.
Yeah.
So you'd very much be in the mix with them. And so now, as we kind of look forward again, just like 400 hurdles and 400, but looking at the 400 hurdles, the landscape is so competitive. But also, I feel like it's one of the spotlight events. Like we said, the last event at the US Olympic trials in
Yeah.
Grand Slam track, you're gonna have yourself, there'll be Shamir Little, there'll be Sydney McLaughlin-Levrone. Like all of you are literally some of the fastest in history. What makes the event so special? Like, how is it like this premier event and everyone is just like hitting on all cylinders right now?
No, I think maybe just the way that like when we get together, we're able to push the event forward and do things that no one's ever done before. I think like a lot of events, people are trying to get to the old records and do things that are like that have been done and kind of bring that glory days back. But I think the 400 hurdles for women is definitely in some of its glory days. Like people are going to be talking about these races and these heats for a while. And yeah, I think we all know that it's we're part of something special right now, and that's really motivating to get out there and be, you know, in the front of the pack or just be like up in the mix to get those times down.
Nice. Well, very dope. So before we end off, what's like, as we look forward to the season, what's maybe the most exciting thing that you're looking forward to with 2025, with Grand Slam track, with everything that's kind of coming up on the horizon?
Definitely to travel, I think. You know, try that open four, see what I can do in that. Bring my 400 hurdle time down even more. I think there was lots of progress last year, but I think definitely even more can be made. Always trying to get it as low as possible. And I don't know, definitely just to like to get my feet wet in this pro world and to just make my little presence known in this big old track world that we all love.
There you go. Well, in my opinion, your presence is like you have a very, very strong presence already in the track world.
Thank
You've made
you.
a huge mark. So, yeah, I feel like 2024 was just a start, and 2025 is going to be a huge splash. So,
Yeah.
nice. Well, Jasmine Jones, really appreciate it. Excited for next year. Excited to have you as a racer as part of Grand Slam track and to see you on your first professional season in track and field here. So,
Yes.
no, thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you.